Welcome to Faith Family Worship Center in Palm City, Florida. Thank you for being a part of our service here today. And we want you to take a few moments and to find that click and share button that is there right here in the comments. Thank you so much for sharing this service with your friends and family. Invite somebody to come and join with you and to enjoy this service for the next few minutes. We're going to take a few moments to discover hope and allow God's Word to change our lives. Now, if you're new to Faith Family Worship Center, please text NEW to FFWC at 77948. That's NEW to FFWC at 77948. Takes you to a secure link. We just ask a couple of quick questions, and I'll send you an email thanking you for being a part of this service today. It's real important. You're important to us, and we would love to be able to connect with you and make you a part of our family. Join us now as we get ready to worship God. Now, normally in service, we would raise our hands, we would clap our hands, we would sing. Feel free to do so where you're at if you can, to join with us as we worship God for the next few minutes. Thank you so much for being a part of what God is doing, and now let's worship the Lord together.
Jesus, the Lamb that was slain. turns to light. As we pray, the will of God and man alike. With one voice we lift our hands to say, we only trust in Jesus' name. Lord of mercy, hear this prayer.
Take a few moments and let's just praise God and just to thank Him for everything that He has done for us. Father, we love You, we thank You, we praise You, and we worship You. Your name is above all names. Your name is above every need that we face. Your name is who we glorify above all that is happening in this world. While the world is in this chaos from the COVID pandemic, we know that You are in control. And we give You praise and worship and glory for that with all of our heart and soul and spirit. Now I pray for people here in this place. I pray that You will touch them, take care of them, look out after them. I pray for our country. As we go through this crisis and we're coming out the backside, I pray that You will help provide for our every need. Keep us healthy. Keep this country healthy. Give our leadership wisdom. Father, I pray for those who are on the front lines of nurses and doctors and first responders that You will keep them safe. But I pray for every person here that you will put a hedge of protection around them and their family. Lord, we will do due diligence with our wisdom, but we need your protection. Guide us and direct us. I pray for every person here who needs a healing in their body. I rebuke cancer in the name of Jesus. I rebuke depression in the name of Jesus. Lord, we speak against those things that come against us and provide you the opportunity with our faith for you to do a miracle in our lives. And Lord, we submit ourselves to you that in all things you will be glorified. Restore our hope. Put joy back in our hearts. Keep our marriages strong. Keep our families strong. And Lord, we will thank you and praise you for it with everything that is within us. Be glorified in our lives, and we'll thank you for it. In Jesus' name we pray. And everybody said, hashtag amen. Go ahead and put that in the comments below. And thank you so much for being a part of what God is doing here today at Faith Family Worship Center. Well, first of all, let me ask you a question. Have you ever made a promise that you later regretted? Well, probably all of us have at one time or another. You didn't understand what you were making the promise to, or maybe you just overestimated your skills. You wanted to do it, but in the end discovered that wasn't going to be the case. I did something like that as a teenager back in my home church in Rogers, Arkansas. I looked out on the front lawn of our church sign and saw that it was in pretty bad shape. It needed a facelift. And so right in the middle of summer, I decided I was going to go out and paint this sign. That probably wasn't the best time of year for me to do it, but what did I know? But the problem was, is I couldn't get the paint from the can to the sign fast enough. It was already drying. It was so hot. It was miserable. And in the middle of all of this, I discovered I'm not a sign painter. I have no skill whatsoever to be out here doing what I'm doing. And I was determined to get it done, and I stayed out there every day, and I kept working on it. And then finally, they bailed me out and hired a sign painter to finish it for me and got me out of trouble. I really desperately did try. Maybe you've been there too, that you've tried to do things before, but you seem to have failed at it. We've all made promises we couldn't keep, and we've had promises broken that were made to us. It's painful, but it's true. We've all been there. We've all done that. And too many people think that God will break his promises. The truth is, he can't do it. There's no way that God can break his promises. God cannot lie. And because of that, that means his promises are true yesterday, today, and forever. Now, we struggle sometimes with how he does it. And we might struggle whenever he says, not right now. But never allow yourself to think that he has abandoned you. He has never abandoned you, nor will he ever, ever abandon you. The hope that you have every day is its foundation is in his promises. Ask God to build your hope today and put it in his hands. Jesus said in Matthew 7:7, ask and it will be given to you. Seek and you will find. Knock and the door will be opened to you. What hope there is in that statement that God says, I stand ready, come to me, and I will be everything that you need. In your worst moment of pain and despair, in your greatest joys and victories, God is there with you all the time. If you need a miracle today, text pray for me to 77948 or hit the live prayer button that is located there in the comments. There is somebody there standing by ready to pray with you at this very moment. There is a team of people who will continue to pray for your need as we pass it on to them and will continue to pray for you this week. We believe in prayer. We believe in the power of prayer. We believe that God answers prayer. And write that down. Pray for me to 77948 somewhere. You can use that day or night. It does not matter. 24/7, we stand ready to agree with you and believe that God will give you hope. Know that we are your virtual family if you live outside of this area, but we are here for you to help you, guide and lead and direct you. And God has been blessing us with these connections, these digital connections that are now starting to go across this country and now starting to cross country lines into other countries where we have been ministering to people online and virtually. Thank you so much for being a part of that. And we invite you to continue to stay connected with us. Now, I want to thank you for your faithfulness, for those who are tithers and givers. I want to thank you because you have done so much through this crisis. God has richly blessed you. God has richly blessed us, and I believe that. It's like this glass of water that's right here, a moment. That's good water. And I enjoy having to be able to drink good, clean water. But did you know that there are large portions of our world where people don't have access to something just as simple as this? Now, the same can be said about food. The same can be said about shelter and health care, a lot of different things. But Jesus said in Matthew chapter 25, verses 34 through 36, "Then the king will say to those on his right, 'Come, you who are blessed of my Father, inherit the kingdom prepared for you from the foundation of the world. For I was hungry, and you gave me food. I was thirsty, and you gave me drink. I was a stranger, and you welcomed me. I was naked, and you clothed me. I was sick, and you visited me. I was in prison, and you came to me.'" Now, Jesus is making a clear point to his disciples about serving people in need. As a church, we believe that we should serve those in our community and our world. Your giving last week allowed us to send a generous check to Teen Challenge, Davie Teen Challenge Women's Home. And thank you for being able to do that. And I know that will be a big, huge blessing to them, especially in this time whenever they cannot raise funds. They are quarantined like everybody else. And this week we're going to help a family who has lost their primary income and is struggling right now. We want to be able to be of assistance to them. And if you want to give above your tithe and offering to help them out, and you want to go to give to FFWC to 77948. Just text that, give to FFWC to 77948. And there in the secure link that you will receive, you can go to our online portal and just give under other. Or if you are giving it in some other way, just make a notation to us and we'll see to it that 100% of what you give goes to be able to help them out. For this family, for their kids, it's a time of need. And we can be there for them, even if it's in just a small way. We want to be able to do that. You see, the strength of this church's culture of giving makes a difference. And we are givers. Why are we givers? Because God is a giver, and we want to be more like him. If God has given everything to us, we surrender everything back to him and be a blessing unto the world that is around us. So let's make this difference together. Thank you for your tithe. Thank you for your offering. Thank you for your faithfulness. And thank you for keeping FFWC strong. As we go through these next few weeks of going through these phases of reemerging and discovering our new normals and everything that we see, this is critical and important, especially at this time, that we remain faithful in our giving. I pray that God will give you a blessing, and I'm going to do that in a moment. We'll bless your finances, continue to bless your job. I know some of us have lost jobs, some of us have had slowdowns, some of us have had to adapt to get new jobs. But I pray that God will continue, and yet you will continue to look to him to be your provider. He will take care of our needs. God has our back, and he's going to see us through. Father, I pray a blessing upon every person who is giving faithfully, who is giving of what they have. It isn't about the amount, God. It's about our obedience and recognizing that you are our provider. You are the one who gives us everything that we have, and we thank you for that. Lord, thank you for your blessing. Now use us to be a blessing to others, to reach outside as we are right now in our communities, in our neighborhoods, to share hope and give hope and to make hope a reality in somebody's life today. May we speak it and sing it and be it to everyone around us, and we will thank you for it. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Well, here are a few things that are coming up here at Faith Family Worship Center. I'll be back in just about, in about a minute, and thank you for your giving your attention to these announcements. Thank you for giving your attention to those announcements. Many things are happening here at Faith Family Worship Center. Make sure you always check your emails, our weekly emails that come out usually around Friday or Saturday for any new announcements. And also make sure that you stay connected with us online at our website at ffwc.us. Now, we've started reopening the church for Sunday services, but in order for you to be able to attend, you've got to reserve a seat. It's important because we're only at 25% capacity, and according to CDC guidelines, not only can we use 25% capacity, but we also must maintain the 6-foot distance. And you can learn more about this at our website, ffwc.us, and click on Services. There you will find an online form that allows you to attend an 8 a.m. service. You can also attend our hybrid Hope Group Faith Skills with Randy Shore at 9:15 a.m. So if you're online, you can still do it online while we are here doing it physically here in this sanctuary, and then our 10:30 service. So make sure that you get your reservation in, because once we hit the cap, we have to stop. And then we would either refer you to another service, which isn't full, or just have to tell you you can't come until we get into phase two, which allows us for a little bit more growth at that particular point in time. But we're doing everything we can in order to be able to return and to be able to see, look forward to that day, which will probably be a little while from now, that to see us be able to be back here together worshiping as we did before all of this started. But until then, we are going to be open, and we welcome you to be a part of it, but make sure you make that reservation first before you do that. Well, welcome to the fifth week of Finding Hope. We, coming through all of this, one thing that I have seen over and over again is people looking and grasping for answers to questions, to overcome problems, to meet new challenges. And in order to be able to do that, you have to have hope. If you don't believe you're going to make it, guess what? You're not going to make it. And hope gives you the ability to see beyond the problem that is in front of you right now. And that's what God does in your life. He lets you see beyond the crisis that we're in, what you're going through. And he gives us the hope to know that through all of it, he will never abandon us, and that there are answers to questions that we don't have a clue what to do with. If you're following the journey of Jesus through the gospel, you will discover that he made a number of promises, and that some of these promises are located in I will statements, when he said, I will, and he makes a promise to us. These statements that he made are designed to strengthen your faith and to help give you hope today. In Ephesians 3:20, it says, Now all glory to God, who is able, through his mighty power at work within us, to accomplish infinitely more than we might ask or think. Can you imagine that God has something planned for you that is bigger than what you can imagine? I want you to imagine the greatest thing that you think that you can do for God, and then realize that God can do more. God's better than what we can imagine or think, and too often we limit what we can do as a follower of Jesus, or we limit what we can do as a church because, quite frankly, we think too small. But hope gives us the ability to think beyond that, to think bigger, and to accept challenges that are so big that only God would be able to do it. And those are the kind of dreams that God will drop into your hearts. Remember that your dreams have to be bigger than your memories. And so as you move into the future of your life, as we move into the future as a church, we're looking forward to seeing what God will challenge us in these times and days ahead. Jesus declares his plan to build his church all the way through the Gospels. He came to return and to establish his kingdom here upon this earth, to give us the Holy Spirit, who is here to help us experience infinitely more until his return. Every promise from Jesus originated from his Father and was guided by the Holy Spirit. He just didn't randomly just blurt stuff out, and then God, the Father, is up in heaven going, "Did he just say that?" No, no. These statements originate from heaven. They are given to us by God's word. And these "I will" statements became instant truth the moment that Jesus said them. So it's my desire today that these statements would encourage your hope and faith to cause you to seek the fulfillment of each statement in your life. The first one is found in Matthew chapter 4:19. "Follow me, and I will make you fishers of men." Now Jesus calls on this group of fishermen to be his disciples, and he calls on them to drop their nets and follow him, and they do. He's using the common analogy to help them understand a simple principle. He's got greater things in store for them than just fishing. Who doesn't want to be told, "Hey, I see more potential in you than you see in yourself"? I challenge you to say that into somebody's life. Speak that into somebody's life. And if they look at you like you've lost your mind, don't be surprised. Because without hope, we can't see the potential that God has created us to have. If God says, "Put down that shovel, put down that pencil, put that camera down, set that computer aside," whatever it is that he says, understand that there is more potential in you than you can even begin to imagine. And so when he says, "I will make you," that's exactly what he means. He's going to do his will and purpose in your life to recreate you to be everything he created you to be. Seek God first and you will discover who he created you to be, more than you can ask or think. The second statement is, "I will give you rest." Matthew 11:28. Now, this is a great moment when he says, "I will give to you." God isn't greedy. God doesn't steal from you. He's a giver. He gives you hope. He gives you rest. He gives you faith. He gives you purpose. He gives you vision. He gives you promises. He gives so much. When we realize how much that God has given to us, he gives us his grace and his mercy and his forgiveness and the Holy Spirit and the Word of God and a family that we can connect with and all these things. God gives and gives and gives. And that's why we don't want to be greedy or selfish with what we have, because it's not a true reflection of who lives in our hearts to be that way. We want to be givers, as God has given unto us. Now, these next statements are pretty encouraging. He says, "I will never reject you." John chapter 6, verse 37. "I will love you and reveal myself to you." John chapter 14, verse 21. And if you ask me anything in my name, I will do it. John 14:14. Look at all the great things that Jesus is declaring that he will do for us. I want you to be encouraged today. Jesus is going to be with you every step of the way. For right now, in the middle of this crisis, our sight may be a little short because it's like the meme that I saw on Facebook the other day that said, the most useless thing that I have bought this year was a 2020 planner. Boy, isn't that the truth? Having a plan and working out schedules and working out a calendar, some of us can't see past 24 hours. Some of us can't see past a week. It's just amazing how we can become so short-sighted. And right now, the time calls for it. We don't know what's going to happen next. But God does. And he said, I will do it. We have to believe that the next week, the month, the next year, God is already there. He's already in it. He's already provided. And that's his promise to us, is that that is exactly what he's going to do. The disciples, whenever they hear this, have to be going, wow, man, did we pick the right leader or what? This guy is amazing. And we should have that same excitement in our own hearts. Jesus, I've picked Jesus. Jesus has picked me. We are in this relationship, and it is wonderful, and it's awesome. Now, the next statement that Jesus makes probably left the disciples a little bit baffled. You have more insight into this now than they did whenever he said it. In Matthew 16:18, I will build my church. I will build my church. Here's the deal. The disciples had no idea what he was talking about. A church? I'm sure they're looking at each other go, church? See, Jesus wasn't talking about a building. He wasn't talking about a denomination. He wasn't talking about anything along those lines. He was talking about a movement. Jesus was declaring that he was going to build his kingdom here on earth, in our hearts. He's declaring that he's going to build a movement of people who are called by his name to go out and push back the darkness that exists in this world. And that's probably what you have had to discover how to do during this crisis, because I know many times that hell has tried to discourage and tried to rip my joy away from me. Many challenges have come, and it's only been through prayer and seeking God in worship that I've been able to push those things out and back. But how exciting can this be to know that we have the authority? Jesus says, I will build. What is he building? He's building you and me to be the ones that will go out into this world and push back the walls of darkness that try to limit our minds, our hearts, to keep our faith small, to destroy hope in marriages and families. The Greek word for church is ecclesia, means to call out, to be called out from. The image is that you and me are being called out of our homes into the marketplace. And that is still a reality today. To be called out from sin, to be called out from a lifestyle that's like this world, into a new life, into new hope. That's what God wants to give you. That's what he wants to build in you. He wants to call you out from all this junk that's going around and says, I want to do a new thing in you today. I want to build you a new life. I want to build in you and recreate you. If I don't go away, then I will send him, the Holy Spirit, to you. John chapter 16, verse number 7. Now, again, this has had to be a statement that the disciples had to look at each other going, wait a minute, say that again. What did you just say? You're going to go away, but you're going to send the Holy Spirit? That was new to them. This was language that they would have not been real familiar with. Jesus comforts the disciples and us by promising to send another helper. We're not alone. We've got backup. He is here for us. Jesus was about to go away. We know this at his ascension. And the one coming would be just like him, but without the limitations of a physical body. And we see the fulfillment of this in Acts chapter number 2. The Holy Spirit is your counselor. He's your advocate. He's your strengthener. He's your comforter. He's your helper. He's your advisor. He's your ally. He's your intercessor. And he's here for you right now. Oftentimes we think that, well, we've got to be in church. We've got to be in a holy place to experience God. That holy place is in your heart. That holy place is right there in the living room where you're seated. That holy place is right there at work where you're watching. If you're driving on the road in a car, that's the holy place right now. You're there. The Holy Spirit is there with you. Jesus promised that he would be there and always would be there for you. Accept him into your life now. And accept the reality that he's there and stands ready to do a work within you as you give your life to him. In John chapter 14, verse number 3, Jesus said, I will come back. I will return. Jesus promised that he would return. There's no reason why we shouldn't believe him. Jesus said he would rise from the dead, and he did. Jesus said that he was going to go to the Father, but he would send the Comforter. He did. Jesus said that we would call upon his name and he would answer our prayers. He does. There's no reason to believe that he isn't going to keep his promises. He has done nothing but keep his promises to us. So what do these I will declarations mean to you and to me today? Exactly, they say the same thing they meant to the disciples over 2,000 years ago. Jesus will show us how to reach our world. Jesus will give us rest. He will never reject us. He will never abandon us. He will love us. He will reveal himself to us in new and wonderful ways. He will use us to build his church, his kingdom in our lives and in the lives of people that are around us. He will give us the Holy Spirit, and someday he's going to return and take us home. If you want hope in your life, your church, your family, your future, then align your heart and life with his great plan. In Matthew chapter 6, verses 9 and 10, Jesus taught the disciples how to pray. And there he says, then this is how you should pray, our Father in heaven, holy is your name. Your kingdom come down from heaven. Your will be done over mine, on earth as it is in heaven. When you give God all that you have, he becomes all that you need. Let me say that again. When you give God all that you have, he becomes all that you need. The disciples gave up everything in order to be able to follow Jesus. In return, they helped create the greatest movement that has ever been on this planet. If you made God's will, what would happen? If you lined up your will with what he wants done, what do you think will change? I believe that you will be able to accomplish infinitely more than you can ask or think, that you will discover the joy that you're looking for. There are people out here listening to my voice, and you're struggling, and you're trying to find hope in relationships. You're trying to find hope in addictions. You're trying to find hope in doing things your way, trying to control the relationships around you, manipulate situations to your favor. Doesn't happen. You will never know hope. You will never know joy until you give it to God and submit your will to his. Do you want hope today in your life? Click those hearts below. Just go ahead and click them. I want hope. Line them up. Hit it 20 times. I don't care. But I want you to know there is hope. There is hope. What hope do you need? What is it that you're looking for? The hope that comes from following Jesus by giving your life to him, to experience his love and forgiveness, that comes from repenting of your sins and giving your life to him, just surrendering everything to him and saying, I'm here. I'm sorry for being a sinner, but I accept you as my Savior. Do you need rest? His rest. Are you tired of trying to survive through this COVID crisis? You're exhausted. Ask him for help and strength. Ask Him to renew your mind and your spirit. Do you want to see your world experience hope? Do you want to see the world experience the hope that you know? Do you have a desire to reach your neighbor, to reach your community, to reach the lives that are around you? We should have a hunger to be able to do that. Jesus said, I will help you do just exactly that. If your answer is yes to one or more of those, then hashtag on here, I raise my hand. Just go ahead and hashtag it. Let us know. Yeah, I need hope. I want to give hope. I want to know His rest. I need a refreshing in my heart and my life right now. Holy Spirit, I pray that as you're there in that place, wherever people are at, Lord, this broadcast replays all day, every day. I don't know who's going to watch this. I have no idea. This is a divine appointment between you and them. And thank you, Lord, that we're just able to be here to do this. I pray that, God, you would begin to do a work in all of these lives. I pray for people who need to give their life to you, to submit it wholly, all of it. As they pray a sinner's prayer, forgive me of my sins, Lord Jesus. I know I've done wrong. Help me. You're the Son of God. You died on a cross. You rose again. I believe in you, but I need you to come into my heart and change me to be more than I can imagine. I pray, Lord, for people who are just exhausted. They're tired. Give them rest. Refresh their spirit. Refresh the joy. Refresh the joy of their salvation. Pour it out upon them. God, I pray, restore their hope. Do a work in their life right now. And I pray for people who want to give this hope away, who see this time as the greatest opportunity to share the love of Jesus with their world. I pray that you will encourage them, empower them, that you will be able to give them the opportunity to be able to speak hope into people's lives in Jesus' name. Lord, we will thank you for that. May we speak the hope of Jesus to ourselves, to our world. Let us sing the praises of God for all the world to hear. Let us be hope to those around us, picking up those who have stumbled, those that are in need, and to build a life together that is shared. We thank you for this. In Jesus' name we pray. And everyone said, hashtag amen. God bless you for being here today. Thank you so much for being a part of this service. We welcome you and invite you to connect with us. New to FFWC at 77948. If you need prayer, pray. Put that in there, 77948. And if you want to give, please do so. Go to our website at ffwc.us, and you can learn more about us and how you can connect to us. Welcome you to be a part of this service and any one of our hope groups that we have online. We thank you so much for being here today. God bless you. May the Lord bless you and keep you. The Lord make His face shine on you, be gracious to you. The Lord turn His face toward you and give you peace. God bless. Have a great week.